And if you look up toward the center of the display line right now, you'll see one of our rescuers playing the part of a injured casualty out there and waiting to be rescued by the helicopter. The crew of the AB-212 this afternoon, in the left seat flying his aircraft in command, is Lieutenant Colonel Salvatore Mendito of the Italian Air Force. His co-pilot for the flight is Staff Sergeant Norman Shibe Ross of the AFM Air Wing. And the two rescuers taking part in the demo today, Gunners Damian Gregg and Gunner John Ferrugia. Colonel Mendito now, having made a visual ID of the casualty needing assistance, maneuvering the helicopter back into the center of the display area, pulling the nose of the aircraft back as he slows down into a hover. Now, if you look really, really closely at the right side of the helicopter, you'll be able to see the door opening up now, and the winchman on board the helicopter preparing the winch to lower a rescuer to the rescuer that's already on the ground simulating casualty. The aircraft now stabilized in the hover. The rescuer hanging off of the winch on the side of the aircraft, being lowered down to the casualty. The amount of coordination and precision required to perform such a maneuver is phenomenal. Right now, the pilot will be using all the visual cues around him and information provided to him by the crew members on board to make sure that he's in fact in a stable hover and the aircraft is actually within safety limitations. Rescuer down on the ground now, giving first aid to the rescuer that's on the ground. Now, due to the high level of noise and usually the dust that's flying around during the rescue operation, all communications are usually done by hand signals. The rescuer will give certain hand signals, requesting either types of equipment, requesting to be picked up, anything basically that he needs from onboard the helicopter while he's on the ground. The aircraft, having lowered stretcher to the rescuer, gets the winch up signal by the rescuer on the ground. The winch going back up to the aircraft. As the rescuer takes care of the casualty and starts loading him onto a stretcher. Lieutenant Colonel Mendito now maneuvering the aircraft away from the casualty on the ground. And while the rescuer is tending to the casualty, we'll give a very brief demonstration of the capabilities of the aircraft. Pulling the nose of the aircraft back, adding power, and actually taking off backwards. Lowering the nose down, the aircraft will accelerate to almost 100 knots. And the pilot speeding away, banking around to the right. The crew of the helicopter now approaching the rescuer and the casualty on the ground, slowing the aircraft down, stabilizing into a steady hover. The winch coming down to pick up the rescuer and the casualty. Now earlier before I said that hovering a helicopter is extremely difficult. Added to this, the helicopter from its position is going to take on the weight of two people instantaneously. And the having taken the weight of the rescuer and the casualty in the stretcher being taken up to the aircraft. As the winch comes up to the level of the aircraft, the rescuer maneuvering the casualty in the stretcher into the helicopter with the assistance of the crew on board. Nodding to the crowd, thanking you for being here today with us. Now, adding power to the aircraft and climbing vertically while spiraling around to his right. The AB-212 has a maximum takeoff weight of 6 tons.